Welcome back. Two groups clashed on Sunday evening over the leadership issue of Masjid Committee at Madgaon. A group led by Sheikh Jinnah and another by Irfan Mullah allegedly assaulted each other. Two people from Irfan Mullah's group were arrested on Tuesday morning, but Altaf Sayed from the group is absconding. Riots between two groups rocked Madgaon. Two groups clashed on Sunday evening over an appointment of Masjid Committee. Two groups led by Sheikh Jinnah and Irfan Mullah alias Bablu got into confrontation over the leadership of Masjid Committee at Madgaon. Later, both the groups filed a complaint at Maina Kurturi police station. On Tuesday morning, group led by Sheikh Jinnah protested outside the police station demanding arrest of the opposite group for allegedly hitting them on Sunday. The police later arrested two people, Jubir Khan and Badpir Sheikh from Bablu's group.
Accordingly, both the parties were summoned today morning at 9:00 hours in the morning. And one party is arrested under section 151 of CRPC. Two persons arrested today morning, namely Dadapir Sheikh and Jubir Khan. Both of them arrested under section 151 of CRPC.
Sheikh Jinnah criticized the opposite group.
Ya main isu da karta mehram bitar kay na ekuz ek korba lafdi korbache ya manish amchi popular front ek bari samaj sagla ghun chalbache tu comedy bare hindu muslim kristan bhava te de religion tanka burgya maro bale shiklale burgya educate burgya katle kida asla function problem dalle te osun papache manish tenche religion tanka marpa tanka dadagiri या दादागिरी कोण आ त्यांच्यावर मर्डर केसचं केस हा गुंड चोरीचं केस हा रेप केसचं केस हा आणि पोलीस काय ऍक्शन घेणार.
On the other side, Irfan Mullah, who is also the president of All Goa Muslim Minorities, had something else to say.
वयल्या अजिमणा जेना झगडी झाली त्यांना तेमी जवळजवळ 60 लोकांनी पर्सनल एजर आपली कंप्लेंट फाइल केली. ते कंप्लेंटचे काय ऍक्शन जाऊ ना किद्याक जाऊ ना खय ती फाइल पेंडिंग पडता आणि प्रॉडली का प्रेशर होता पीआयचेर आणि तो बाबडो ओगीत रावता ते कामाक हे एका तुम्ही सोदून काढपा जाय की यांचे फाटल्यान जो पॉलिटिकल पॉवर असा वो कोण बॅकिंग दिता वेदर इज काँग्रेस पार्टी दिता काय बीजेपीचे लोक दिता ते तुम्ही सोदून काढपाचे काम प्रेसाक सगळ्यांक खबर आहे याच्या फाटल्यान कोण काम करता तो तुम्ही फक्त काँग्रेस पार्टीक ब्लेम करून हे असले म्हणजे चोरांक यांची चोरी केस कितली आहा रेप केस कितली आहा हे तुम्ही काढपाचे काम प्रेसाचे काम आणि पोलिसांचे काम हे आमचे असले काँग्रेसमॅनाचे काम न्हू.
Police informed that one person named Altaf Sayed is absconding and will be arrested soon. A reporter in Madgaon, Ramesh Naik Raut.
Kadam brothers have denied the allegations made by Bobby Kapoor and Fareed Khan in the alleged land deal fraud. Kadam brothers had sold the land at Velsa and Karwa to the Delhi-based party, but the party alleges they are cheated. Kadam brothers say the Delhi-based party intended to dupe and defame them.
Bhushan Shivanand Kadam and Atul Shivanand Kadam have rubbished all the allegations made by Bobby Kapoor and Fareed Khan. Kadam brothers were alleged of deceiving the Delhi-based duo over a property at Velsau and Karwar. The party had filed complaint at Panji police station on 16th February.
Came to know that he has filed a police complaint against us. Though my name was not figuring. It was Mr. Bhushan Kadam and Atul Kadam, and he made false allegations that we have duped him regarding these properties which did not have clear titles. Our clarification on this ground is, as far as the property matters are concerned, which he is talking about, that he has paid money and we have not given him properties. We have got all these supporting documents with us where sale deeds are executed and all documents are here.
Kapoor and Khan had alleged that Kadam brothers had not transferred the property titles purchased by them. But Bhushan denied the allegations.
For that clarification, we have given one more document which he submitted to Income Tax Office, Ward No. 2, Margaon. Second page of that, we have highlighted the following amount to Mr. Bhushan Kadam towards purchase of land at Goa and Karwar, for which the sale deed has been partially executed and the remaining amount is due on account of land to be bought from him in Karwar area. See the date. It is dated 15-12-2009. Now he is saying orderly started in 2007. So down the year 2007, 2008, 2009, he is furnishing this document to Income Tax Office.
Kadam brothers also denied the allegation of duo that they were threatened.
He is talking about that was carried to Marriott and showed whatever he has been alleging. How can anybody carry a pistol to Hotel Marriott where they have got metal detectors, they have got frisking, they got CCTV, and he himself has very clearly mentioned that the meeting took place in the lobby, which is the open public.
A reporter in Panji, Devidas Kamli, with video journalist Omkar Filari.
A priest from Pilar has introduced a new concept of contract farming. The unique method helps in cultivating fallow land which otherwise lies barren. And the result from such practice is quite rewarding, says Father Patrick D'Souza.
Father Patrick D'Souza is the director of Pilar Nature Farm. Father D'Souza took over Father Ignacio Almeida, who has done pioneering work at the farm in the past. At present, many vegetables as well as fruit-bearing trees are being planted at the farm. Under the Rashtriya Krishi Vikas Yojana, he procured farming equipment like a transplanter, harvester and a sprayer under a subsidized rate. But what is interesting is that Father D'Souza engages in a unique concept called contract farming. People who own plots but do not cultivate anything on it give the plot to Father D'Souza for farming activities. Recently, a former model, Tinu Verghese, offered her plot to Father D'Souza for cultivation.
One person called named Tinu Verghese, so she approached me saying that, Father, I also wish to that my plot be cultivated. I don't want it to be to remain just fallow. So that's why, like I said, if it is possible for me, I will definitely do that.
Father D'Souza also practices vermiculture. The composting pits were originally constructed to compost waste from the municipality, which did not materialize. Now Father D'Souza himself uses the available waste generated from his farm, which he uses for generating compost. He says the entire activity of generating compost takes 35 days.
One of the activity that I have taken up is this vermicomposting. It is only with the continuation of what Father Ignacio had, the idea of making our soil fertile. It is that effort that I am trying to continue. Maybe I am not able to get the municipality waste and help the state in that way. But then whatever waste I have in the farm itself, we use it here. And then cow dung and the farm waste, we put it, and then we have some worms, and the earthworms in that, and it is they who do that.
Our reporter Jason Suarez with video journalist Ganesh Hotkar.
Public Accounts Committee paid a surprise visit at Asilo Hospital on Tuesday. They want government to start the operation of new district hospital at Mapsa, as Asilo is ill-equipped to fulfill the needs of the patients.
Manohar Parrikar, along with MAPSA MLA Francis D'Souza, TV MLA Nilkanth Halankar, Health Secretary Rajiv Verma, Health Director Rajnanda Desai paid a surprise visit to Asilo Hospital on Tuesday. They visited each and every ward of the hospital. The queues were endless. They paid visit to toilets too. After understanding the situation at Asilo, Parrikar has demanded to start the operations of new district hospital at Mapsa, which is lying unused from past 1.5 year, immediately.
Patients who are crammed there, almost doesn't look good for human beings, the conditions there. The space is too less, constrained, there's no place to seek. Sick people, they can't sometimes stand. But then someone has to stand because others are also sick. So I think this is a place where everyone can sit and that can take care of next 10-15 years of North Goa's problem. So this should be started immediately.
MAPSA MLA and Member of Public Accounts Committee Francis D'Souza said that upgradation can be done later on, But at present, some units can be shifted from Azilo to New District Hospital.
My demand is that whatever specialization they want to get from outside, they are free to do it. But whatever facilities are available here, they should be started, including the morgue. There's a 12-unit morgue here. Director tells me that water supply will start tomorrow. So tomorrow onwards, they can shift some of the units from the Azilo to this place. Whatever specialization they have to get in, they can get it later on.
A reporter from MAPSA, Shamsundar Fatte, for Prudent Media.
Stay tuned to Prudent for more news after a short break.